channel. In case you didn't guess from that intro, today I'm going to be doing the Little Mix Perry Edwards shout out to my ex makeup tutorial. This is from the first half of the video where she's got the stars on her eyes, because I think this is so cool. I'm not going to lie, this was quite hard to recreate because I looked through a ton of photos and every photo the eyeshadow looked different. Like one photo it looked just like really creamy gold, another one it looked pink, another one it looked bronze. So I actually watched the makeup artist that did this, his name is Adam. He actually did a video to recreate the look and I've basically gone from that video hoping that he is actually being real and that is what he actually used in the video. I haven't used the exact same products apart from a few things, but that is where I've gone from. So I've definitely gone for more of the pinky shimmer tone on the eyes. So anyway, that was a super long intro. Don't forget to click the subscribe button if you enjoy this video, and let's just get straight into it.
Okay, so starting off, I've already prepped my face with my Farsali Rose Gold Elixir Oil, and then moving on to primer, I'm taking my Makeup Forever Smoothing Primer just to prime my face, and this stuff is amazing. Like, look how smooth my skin looks already. We haven't even put any foundation on yet. So that primer is bomb. Moving on to foundation, I'm taking my Too Faced Born This Way foundation. This is in the shade Golden, and I use two pumps of this. This is enough for me. I know a lot of people, I feel like maybe I don't use enough foundation, but to me, two pumps is plenty, right? Anyway, I'm using my Rodale Airbrush foundation brush to buff all over my face, and this gives a really flawless finish super fast. Moving on to concealer, I'm taking the Kevin Aucoin. This is the Essential Skin Enhancer Concealer. This is in the shade SX04, and I'm using my ring finger to first of all warm it up and then blend it under my eyes to highlight and conceal, also on my forehead in between my eyebrows, the bridge of my nose and my chin. This concealer is so amazing. I've had it for ages but I forgot how much I liked it. It gives the most flawless finish and it's such a beautiful color for my particular skin tone. Moving on to setting that, I'm using the Rodale Translucent Setting Powder just to set everywhere we've just highlighted, so underneath our eyes and also onto our eyelids as well, as I did apply some of that concealer there, and everywhere you've just put it. I also do this on my laugh lines, you know, like the smile lines you get around your mouth, just to make sure they're all set. Next, I'm taking the Benefit Hoola Bronzer to contour and bronze up the face. I am using the Kat Von D contour brush to do this. So I'm just taking it underneath my cheekbone and then I'm bringing it up to my temples and forehead and also applying this to my jawline. Next, I'm taking a Iconic London Oval brush to just do a nose contour real quick. This shade is a bit too warm for a nose contour. Once you've blended it out, it's totally fine. But if you're going for quite a dramatic nose contour, then I wouldn't use this shade. I would definitely go for a more greyer toned. Once I've blended that out, I do go back into the Kat Von D shade in light palette and I take the banana shade to really clean up the edges of that nose contour, and it really makes your nose look a lot more snatched because it just like cleans up the lines and hides the real shadow of your nose. So I definitely recommend this step if you do want to do a nose contour. Moving on to blush, I'm taking the Milani Rose D'Amore blush and just using a Real Techniques blush brush to apply that, and then taking Gilded Honey by Laura Geller to highlight my cheekbones. And this highlight is so nice. I know I all about my Inner Mascara Epic, but I feel like because I'm a tiny bit paler now, this works really well. So once you've done that, that is the finished skin. And then moving on to the eyebrows, I'm taking my Rodale eyebrow pencil. This is the Glamour Brow in the shade Ash Brown, and I'm just filling in my eyebrows how I normally fill them in, because she has quite straight eyebrows. Like the first part is much straighter than mine, but I just can't do that with my eyebrows. They'd be way too thick, and I was like, I don't need to have the same brows as her. Like, this is just an inspired look, you know. Moving on to the eyes, I'm taking the ColourPop, this is like a gel cream thing, in the shade Get Paid, and I'm using a e.l.f. concealer brush, first of all, to just buff this onto my eyelid, and then I just pat out the edges with my finger, and then while it's still tacky, you want to take ColourPop Sequin, and this is like a Super Shock shadow, and you just want to push that over the top with your finger before that base has a chance to dry. So you do want to do one eye at a time because you want the base to be tacky before you push this color over it. And can we just talk about how amazing this color is? Like, for real, look at it. Oh my goodness, this color is just everything to me. Like, it's insane. So I'm just doing the exact same thing to the other eyeball, so just applying that base. and then pushing the sequin shadow over the top. I've done this makeup in a complete reverse way that I normally would do. Usually I'd obviously start off with a transitional colour, then deepen up the crease, and then do this part last. But when I watched Adam do his on the tutorial he did, this is how he did it, so I was like, I'm going to try it, and I loved it. So going into the Carly Bybel palette, I'm taking this first transitional shade, which is like a mauve, fairly light, but I'm just using this to buff out the edges of what we just applied, so we don't have any crazy harsh lines or anything, and it's just going to start deepening up the crease. But yeah, this is totally backwards. Like, usually I would do this step first, but yeah, this is how he did it, and I must say that I really like doing it this way. I felt like I had much more control over the shape that my eyeshadow turned out. If that makes any sense. I don't know if it does, but it did. I'll show you what I mean a bit later. Moving on to liner, I'm taking the Whiskey Liner by Urban Decay, but any brown liner would do. And then I tight line, waterline, and also apply it to my lash line. And then I take a flat definer brush to smudge it out. So you're basically creating like a smudged out wing with this liner. So you just want to apply it and then use the brush to actually create the shape. Like, don't actually draw the brown liner in a wing shape because you're going to smudge it into a wing shape. Does that make sense? I think that does make sense. So just keep smudging it out, and then I go back in with another layer of the brown just until you're happy with how like deep and everything that brown shade is. Again, with this step, I do one eye at a time because you don't want to give that liner time to set. You want to start smudging like straight away so it's nice and creamy and easy to blend without yet like getting any harsh lines or anything. So I just did the exact same thing to the other eye. Then I go into this darkest shade in the Carly Bybel palette, which is like a beautiful plum shade. And I'm just applying this to the outer V area, just so that liner kind of blends into it and it also deepens up that outer corner and V, kind of halfway into the crease to give us a bit more shape and definition to the eye, giving it a nice cat eye look. Next, I'm going into the Anastasia palette and taking Burnt Orange. I know, super annoying that I used another palette, but I just felt like it needed a little bit more warmth in it. So I just went in with my fluffy brush with the orange shade just to warm up the look a tiny bit. Next, I'm taking the black coal liner. I'm doing the exact same steps we did with the brown. I'm tight lining, water lining, and putting it on my lash line, and again smudging out with that exact same brush. I've just zoomed in a little bit here so you can kind of see a bit clearer what I'm doing, but I'm literally just smudging out the black liner. And with this, you can be as heavy, go as dark as you want. I think I went in twice with the black liner, but if you want to go even darker, then you could even go over with a liquid liner as well. Or if you want it to be not as heavy, then don't go in twice, just go in once, you know? Going back into that dark plum shade, I'm just deepening up that outer corner one more time, because once you've deepened up the lash line, you need to deepen up the outer corner. So I'm just going back and forth between those steps and also applying it underneath my eye as well. But you can see, like, it's so much easier to see the shape of your eye. Next, I'm going with lashes. These are the Unicorn Lashes in Raven. These are the ones he said he uses. But when I put them on, I was like, these aren't the same. Like, they look really different. I think they're two different lashes, like, for sure. But they were in the box together, so I don't understand. And I don't know if you can tell now that they look different, but I swear in real life they looked really different. I don't know what happened, but they worked. It's fine. I'm highlighting my inner corners and my brow bone with the same highlighter we used on the face, which is the Laura Geller Gilded Honey. Just to highlight those. And then I'm just going in with some brow gel. This is just the Benefit Give Me Brow in the shade Dark. Oh, Peanut just snorted. Just to set my eyebrows and also just make them a little bit more defined and kind of bushy at the front so they kind of stand up. For the lips, I'm taking MAC Strip Down Lip Liner. Look how small my one is, like, for real. It's just the best lip liner. I honestly think everyone should own this lip liner. I think it's a really good lip liner. So I'm just lining my lips with that, and then I'm taking the Huda Beauty Liquid Matte in the shade Venus. Shade Venus, that didn't sound right. And I'm just applying this all over my lips. I love this shade, it's by far my favourite of hers. I haven't tried all of them, but I've tried most of the nude ones, and this is by far my favourite shade, and it's such a beautiful formula. It really does last, and it doesn't feel dry on your lips. Moving on to the cool stars, woohoo! I found these on Amazon. These are actually nail art stars. Do you know how long it took me to find these? Like, no joke, it took me so long to find these. So long. So first of all, I just kind of mapped it up to my eye to see which size I went. I went for the medium. And then taking some tweezers, I'm just working out where it needs to be. And then just, they're already sticky. So I just literally put it where I wanted it, pressed it with my finger, and voila! Woohoo, one star. I love these, aren't they so cool? So then just do the same to the other eye. Try and get them as even as possible. I don't think mine were very even, to be honest. I'm really bad at stuff like that. But yeah, I just patted over them with some translucent powder because they had a very thin, like, clear line around the edge. So I just patted over it so that wasn't shiny. And then I applied some mascara because I realised I'd forgotten to apply mascara. This is just the Too Faced mascara, Better Than Sex. And then once you've done that, the look is complete.
Okay, so this is the finished look, guys. I really hope you like it. I absolutely love this makeup. I would definitely wear this makeup out. I probably wouldn't wear the stars out. Maybe I would. I don't know. But I absolutely love this makeup. So I hope you like it too. Also, this obviously isn't real. I've been thinking about getting my nose pierced for probably about a year. And I don't know whether to get it done or not. So let me know in the comments below if you think I should get my nose pierced. So that's everything for this video. I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.